Nicola Sturgeon has been shunned by Boris Johnson as she tries to secure a second vote on Scottish independence, but a legal expert believes the Prime Minister is, in many ways, powerless to stop the First Minister from getting what she wants. After the 2019 general election, in which the SNP won comfortably in Scotland, Ms. Sturgeon formally requested powers from Westminster to hold a second independence referendum, but the notion was firmly rejected by the Prime Minister. Mr. Johnson said in January, "You and your predecessor, Alex Salmond, made a personal promise that the 2014 independence referendum was a once-in-a-generation vote. The people of Scotland voted decisively on that promise to keep our United Kingdom together, a result which both the Scottish and UK governments committed to respect in the Edinburgh Agreement." However, expert on public law Professor Aileen McCarg told Express.co.uk that the once-in-a-generation argument used by unionists may not work forever. She says that it has no legal backing, and it is difficult to define. Professor McCarg said, "What the UK government are saying is that the SNP said the 2014 vote would be a once-in-a-generation referendum, therefore we are going to hold them to that. The significance of any statement about it being once-in-a-generation are highly dubious, and they have no legal standing. They are in no way legally binding. It's unclear what a generation means. How long is a generation? It has some political plausibility, but the longer this goes on, the less you can rely on that line. It is very uncertain. A lot of this depends on public opinion in Scotland. If support for independence continues to grow, it will become much harder to hold the line for the UK government without significant discontent. Support for Scottish independence has shifted hugely in recent months, with a landmark poll by Panelbase showing that a referendum today would see 55% of voters back leaving the UK. It was based on the same question from 2014 when voters were asked, should Scotland be an independent country? The results were yes 51%, no 42%, undecided 7%. When undecideds were stripped out, the result is 55-45 for yes.